That's one of the things when things like that just disappear. That's very annoying because you actually kind of going to do something and then gone. I was going to say that the fear that my microphone is gone. I was going to talk about containers which float around. When you shoot them, you get gold. So, okay, it gave me both missions for two for one. That's actually not too bad then. The standings with the different guilds, I am fully off with them, so they are not important anymore, but they are quite important to get up. So you start, first of all, can do all levels missions, but also the gifts you get from them when you talk to them on space station or repositories, that is kind of the important thing to do with them. So it's all about kind of doing the right thing. And I always said before that you should wait a little bit before you start doing missions, but I actually realized that is wrong. You can start as soon as you actually can do the missions, why not do them? So if you start out doing some easy ones while you are, well, a little bit undergeared, then yeah, start there and then move to the more difficult ones. You don't want to kill four sentinel quads when you just started the game or the save you're on, but eventually you will be able to do it. And it's a good way of making coins, getting stuff, and of course getting the standings with the guilds. If you notice, I don't go and buy upgrades because there's probably a thing or two I could improve, but at the moment I'm just going with what I have. If I get bored, I sometimes start to micromanage and see if I can improve a little bit. So it does happen, but not so often. Sometimes free stuff. If it's not S-class, I'm not even going to look at it. I'm just going to sell it at those guys. And, yeah. So that became a quick profit. Even though I'm more interested in getting rid of some of my resources, but I do not sell them to lower prices, so I can wait. There's no rush. These rooms sometimes have something on the wall, but not this one. Kind of boring. Thing is, it is what it is. You get what you get, and I'm quite happy with what I in general get, so thing is, you need to keep your eyes open and look around, and you will find things. If you don't, you will miss it. That's how it is. So, that was the wrong one I picked. It was the training, the clusters is the training weapon. Okay. It was not offensive to him, so I'm not getting any storage slot tokens today, so and as I said, take the easy ones if you are just started off. And when you get well geared, then of course you can take the harder ones. The repair and damage items, they always seem to be bugged with me, so I actually avoid them. And I will say, for me it's always, is the risk and the reward in balance. I really don't want to sit with a mission which is very, very risky and the reward is lousy. I don't mind taking the risk if what I get out of it isn't the same class. So, nothing here to do. To make sure I don't have any. I shouldn't have that sitting. So I need to make sure that I keep that running. I have anything to actually run. Oh. another thing I should remember. Go to the sales department and I can actually see I have some of these as well, which can be sold. I always keep some of them, but I actually don't really know why I do. They can be used to gain better standing, but they are also used to find portals with, so sometimes make sure that things are kept in stock if you want to do these things. This is a Viking system. That means there's two times nanite. Apart from that, it's a okay technology level, so might actually be able to do some trade as well. So if you need to sell upgrades, you go into purchase and you take sell, and you just click on those you want to sell. They actually give quite well when you sell them. Cheap boring rooms. I'm going to buy that because it's 25%.
Product received.
But it would have to be better.
Yes.
So what else? It's not really positive that one is. And what is he going to say? So I just swapped some pure ferrite with the nanites. Did I gain? I don't know actually. It's very difficult to actually calculate nanites into money. These, I don't take them anymore because I'm actually done with them. So they just kind of fizz off. But all I advise, go through them and see what happens. I won't tell you because I don't want to give spoilers. Sometimes get it very wrong with the language skills, but oh well. Selling 250 uranium for 500,000 coins. That's a very, very good price. Thank you. I'm not quite sure what the Atlas interference actually implies. I saw something came up on that. Well, let's do it another time. Viruses are not the worst to fight with, so just make sure you keep the shields up too. Sometimes there is containers with, when you shoot them, you get what's in them. They would look like that, but when you shoot them, they would show damage. So there isn't any here. When you find them randomly, then you would kind of find them. With containers, so when you shoot the containers, pirates might appear. Not very smart to do, but hey-o.
Technology
sometimes we need to have some fun. Me getting stuck in the trading post is definitely fun. For everyone else but me. I can tell you. This kind of mission, there's no rush, so you can kind of take it in your own time if you want to. This is a good trading post. There's a lot of stuff for us. These platforms down there sometimes hold things as well. Anything off here? No. And we got all boxes and can actually do what we came here for. Giving him 250 uranium and they are paying me $500,000 for that mission. I am not going to complain. I'm trying to flock some of my resources, so I just realized actually that's only +1%, so that is not, but that is 6%, so I'm gonna get them off. So where's my ship? It's up there. Back to the space station and then I wonder they pack in biscuits like they should never be unpacked. Well, this is really annoying. Come on. So feel free to use the chat if you have questions, comments and stuff. I'll try my best to answer questions if you have any. Nothing cool came up. So, off to next adventure. Always be a little bit careful when you're flying towards a space station and shooting. But if you hit the space station, they might send sentinel interceptors on you, or destroyers or whatever. Sometimes it's actually better just take the hit by the rocks. I do pick these up every time, and I have so many of them, but I still can't let them be. It is what it is. So I might start selling them at some point. Because I have so many. It's a little bit rare. It's actually rare that resources comes in plots, but they do, and it is just about being patient. And that goes with a lot of the investments you do in game here. You need to be patient. I sometimes sit quite a lot of time on the different things I buy. And it's just how it is, really. You could plan where to go and sell what. I almost said you could create your own spreadsheet with what type of systems buy what type of merchandise. Some people do that. I'm a little bit too impatient for that, or disorganized, I would say. But if you really want to earn big money on trade, then you can do better than I do, way better. Can't be bothered to do that. was suddenly a lot I got in one go. Those questions I actually, I can't answer really. So, sometimes they want specific, I can't say current mission, so sometimes they want specific planets, and if you don't do that, then you can't find the place where you could find what you're looking for. Examination, is there any underwater creatures there? This is an abandoned building. A lot of whispering eggs. I'm actually not farming them, but if anyone wants to see the safe way of farming them, especially when you just started the game, then let me know in chat. But the lava core which comes out of whispering eggs is actually quite valuable, especially in the beginning of the game. So you can at least earn some money that way. Or nanites, they can be refined into nanites. things inside. Always check the ceiling because there might be some plants, living plants, which actually lash out. They don't do a lot of damage, but they make you shit yourself when it happens. These corrupted terminals will tell you the story about a traveler, which save something in it for you, and when you analyze data log, you always want to end up getting some nanites. And you can do that multiple times if you wish, so you get more nanites out of it. It is quite handy, again, in the beginning of the game. Later on, that might not be the part you're taking. There's one of those which is if you go in on them, they will lash at you and they will do a little bit of damage, but not overly much. Other than that, there is nothing dangerous inside the building. Danger is outside if you shoot at the whispering eggs, then all these horrors will come swarming and will actually try to kill you. And they might succeed if you're not careful. Quite an eventless day today. What have we found? One exotic, and that's it. Yellowish water. I actually think it is. Oh, Jesus. Okay, it looks like it is. Thank you. it's very warm here. It might be why it's turret. Not always. I need to know about sentinels and stuff.
Extreme hazard planet. Extreme hazard planet. Was not really what I wanted to encounter, but it's not too bad. So jumping around on planets, try to do a little bit more tricky missions. Not difficult, but tricky. Again, one of the parts of the game you can actually do that for hours if you want to. What I did a lot of in the beginning of this save was actually trying to find all the animals on the planet, so I got the bonus nanite. And that actually helped upgrading gear. So again, it's a cheap way of getting something which improve your chances in the game. Interesting, so I will move on to the next system. And I keep this running while I play because it actually I don't have to do it later on. Good evening. Yeah, I'm quite good. You? No, I would say that had a quite eventless eventless game today. It's nothing really happened. It's fighting a little bit with pirates, and that's really the highlight. It's a little bit like I can't get a break. That's the wrong word, I think, but missions has been absolutely dull and the rewards the same. One thing many of us have actually requested that we could customize ships with at least colors, emblems and stuff like that, but nothing have really happened. Wiring loom 41,000, that is rare. Oh. didn't have 300 in stock, then I would buy, but I have stopped at the moment. I don't know if there's a connection, but I think it depends on the system's technological level as well. Well, tech level and trade level. Because it seems like if they are at certain levels, then things are cheaper. So I go and get some more nanites for free. Never know when you need them. Jesus. Even this has been weird today. I got some. Oh, well done. You beat me to it then. Actually, I haven't talked to anyone here, so maybe I should do that. Yeah, I have actually noticed that it seems like one day it's all the same. Once you run into next day is one of the others. In majority, there is of course a little bit of difference, but oh well, I'll get there eventually. Well, I felt for a long time that I was quite close. So my quest is in another system. Yeah. Not my quest, my mission. To be honest, when you go into the galactic map, and let's say that we follow the path to the core, and you see this one was Viking, then the next one is Kovax, then Geg, then Kovax again, Geg, the last one there is Geg. So it comes in weird. I feel it's more like clusters sometimes. I think, but you might run into 2-3 Viking every time you get one of the others. That's, as I said, I sometimes feel one day I'm only seeing one of the races. Yesterday I felt it was mainly Kovax I ran into. Yeah, well, I learned very quickly. If you learn words and you take those language challenges, you might get a lot of quick standing with them, which is actually quite good. Of course, when your standing is fully up, then that's not only what you need, but then for me it started becoming a sport, to be honest.
Pronouns received. Pronouns received. Pronouns received. Okay.
Actually got a question how I could see what there was in the system, and I had to explain that the what that you can actually see it on the icons. Not all have actually noticed that. Actually, have been tempted to, if I start a new save at some point, then take them one by one, so I get one language at a time. But I'm not sure I can do that. It's kind of not really important, because you just need to do what you have to do. That's the thing. There's a lot of things which is not really described anywhere. So you very often end up in a situation where you actually have to decode the information yourself and try to sort out what is it actually. What's the meaning with this? B class with Teed. Now, I would say sometimes other sources is actually better if you're kind of looking for something which you are not 100% sure of. I must admit, I use Reddit a lot for my source. To do more of that as well, but I will probably go back and do it. Do it again, I would say, because I have been doing. I did so I could get enough quicksilver to buy the egg for the living ship, so I have been doing some. Should be possible, I would say. If I remember right, they are relatively cheap. A repair one. No, I do not do repair ones. I actually don't know if it's the same. Case. actually think they are different. On a space station anyway, so why not looking? It's a little bit weird, you can buy decals, you can put them in your base, however. You can't put them on your ships. Why not? It's not like I will... I want to be ungrateful. Yeah? That's quite cool, I would say. Maybe I should invest some of my money and do some freighters. I'm a little bit tempted. Think about that. Yeah, that was what I was thinking. Or you can convert them to nanites. I don't have so many. lost that again. They can also be way worse, so it is really on them. I think you can be lucky and you can be unlucky and then a lot of in between. Because I have a shield on my ship, which is way better than any of my S-class ones, so that is the wrong one. Actually say, where did I get that? Trying to find some goods I lost. Don't put those in my freighter. I should have jumped over. I have a lot of other things. Actually had earlier and sold, so just need to find where I can buy it. See, normally I have those trade goods on my ship I'm flying, so I don't mix it up. But those deliveries, I always keep them on my exosuit, but if I've sold some, it might have gone into that. It wouldn't be the first time I have sold whatever I needed to deliver. It's not always I actually pay attention to what it is I have to do. You grab it and then off we go to do it. But the thing is, I always okay.
that, but mission gave me a little bit of a detour, but that is one of these things that happens. Taking a repair. Yeah, that's you know what NMS stands for? No more sidetracking. aren't we all? Ah.
I think we're very good at that, and I think that's why we love the game, because we you don't harm anything by doing it, and you don't have to follow a straight path for anything. Something else you can do with it. You can make either geodesite or what's the other one? Geodesite by Aronium Magna Gold and Grantine are used to make geodesite. So you take 3, which is worth 25. And make into... What am I saying? I need to double check what I'm saying. Yeah, you take 3, which is 25,000 each, and make them into 150,000. I was on the right track, I just confused myself. Give you some hints. Well, I need. I made a spreadsheet once, so I could actually keep a track on what I came up with. I need to dig it out first. Those I suggested that, to make them doesn't need a refiner, it's just a production. You know, you just go in and then. Is that one? Well, it's under this. So you make that by using those three. Then you double the value of them. How can you run out of silver? Look what I have to sell. My problem is I'm farming it, so that's so I get loads of silver. Yeah, if you keep running out, then I would suggest you do that. It's long ago I have found a S-class. Multi-tool on a space station. So if anyone is interested, I put them so you can see them. Then the core glyphs are there, and you need to be in the Eltiensleen galaxy to use them. But we are on this space station. Look at it again. It's cost 10 million. And it's weirdly enough more expensive than mine, which is filled out with slots. Yeah, but we're on the space station in the goofing Winton system. So it should be easy to find if anyone wants a cool S-class multi-tool. Difficult because I felt in the old days it was more common to find this class, but I might remember wrong. I always found it is a little bit odd because you don't think about it and then suddenly you realize how many hours you spend. Ooh, boxes. It's a good thing when it's a game you play, because if you spend time on it, it means you must enjoy it. Otherwise, I wouldn't say you wouldn't play it then if you didn't. You would have moved on to something else. And then you can't get any closer. I don't even dare look at mine. But this save is only what I have streamed. So I'm not even sure how much I have all in all. Yeah, I do. I have 4 on Battle Pass and 6 at least on Steam. So, yeah. Remember I started this save to actually show a little bit about how you start the game up and how you get into it and stuff like that. That was actually my intention, because I didn't want to just chuck people into far into a game and I thought that might scare someone away. No, you can't. The only thing you can get on a new save is things you have gotten from expeditions and Twitch drops and stuff like that.
actually thinking about starting a permanent game and see how far I can get. Just out of curiosity. Just remember how often I die. That is going to be a challenge. There has been some glitches where I have encountered that in the past as well, where I suddenly ended up far, far ahead from where I was supposed to be. So I think you might have run into the same. I have a feeling that's what caused your jump. Okay. I'm not happy with that, but I need the black hole. I think it was, because it seems to have sorted. Because I have gone through galaxies following the list, so... I actually think it's fine now. Used to be something with black holes as well, where you could that is also fixed, so but the thing is, there is players who have never left the start galaxy, and are quite happy with that. So I mean, you don't have to galaxy jump. If you don't want to, I'll say. I handed user data before I do anything else, so I don't sell it. So
money I got out of this place. Jesus. Well, if anyone is interested, then it can become yours if you come to this trade station and camp out. Price 22.5 million. Well, as I said, until you came on, it was quite eventless, so here's the address. We are in the, on the planet New Ahem, in the northeastern part, and we are in the Ramyanyu system. So I will see the coordinates when we take off. But it's weird, some days, almost no matter where you go, you find things which is very, very good and all that. And other days, you can go all day without actually finding one single thing. It is really weird. Thing is, I'm not even looking for it for myself. I'm kind of stuck up on ships at the moment. It should be something very special. I'm regretting a little bit. I found a squid exotic. I should have taken that, but thing is, I don't want to have too many of the same type of ship either, so it's a little bit. So I need to check the coordinates when we take off. This ship is not good with coordinates. Oh, I'm stuck. Makes it even better. some ships are way better than others. And what I found was red. Very red. Which is kind of my color, so that's... So... The coordinates is plus 1868, minus 50, 30, roughly. Trade station. So well, this is my exotic. That was not really what I wanted. Oh, it's so much talk, and I have one of these. There's some color combinations which you feel it wrong. I must admit I like some of those which look like they are beaten well up, a little bit rusty, a little bit out of the ordinary. Just sold all my silver, that was good. Now I would say there is certain ships that absolutely don't appeal to you. No matter class and all that. get to hit all the ones I don't want to hit. You know, orange is the new black. Decided not to go to this side, and I'm actually glad I did. I like these locker rooms. Two aces in a row, so no. Getting to the point in the game where I will go back to the freighter and clean up. I am starting to get to the point where I feel my bed will be probably be the best option. Oh, you're welcome. But I will say I'm back tomorrow at 8 o'clock UK time, and I will continue creating havoc around and see what happens. And 99 to everyone, and thank you for watching, and please consider following me if you like what you see. And many of the good bits will be posted on YouTube, my YouTube channel as well, so keep an eye out there, so you don't have to sit and watch through 2.5 to 5 hours stream to find that S-class ship you would like. I would say take care, everyone. Have a good night, good evening, good day, no matter what time zone you're in. And see you next time, which will be tomorrow. Good night from the UK.